Reporters came equipped with a big bin of thermometers.
6-7 below zero.
Jerry-rigged to a light stand.
But me, like a genius, I'm standing on a windy bridge.
Dumped unceremoniously.
Woof, it is cold.
When done. For those covering the deep freeze, it's a time of high pressure.
The polar vortex.
The polar vortex.
It's something we call a polar vortex.
It sounds like the name of a band.
Polar vortex.
Or a science fiction movie.
The polar vortex.
Or BuzzFeed suggests maybe a roller coaster or a brand of aftershave or a new term for a brain freeze.
For some of us, the term polar vortex may be something to curse about.
How cold was it? Cold enough to make eyes water and noses run.
I feel like my nose is running and I'm not going to be aware of it.
No, it's your eyes.
So forgive me.
Carson's leaking.
Cold enough to show off props.
Woo!
Well, here's a hamburger and a steak. We left it out and in about 15 minutes, frozen solid.
That is crazy.
Yeah, it's a classic. Listen to it.
Solid.
Even amateurs can't resist. But there's one guy in particular who should have held his tongue instead of using it to demonstrate. Z100 radio personality Greg T.
My tongue is on.
Teed up his tongue to see if it really would stick.
Oh my God, it's on. It's not coming off!
Not quite as cute as the Christmas Story scene that inspired the stunt. Greg T. finally got his tongue untied by pouring water over it. It was so cold that a prison escapee in Kentucky turned himself in. Robert Vick came to this motel and asked them to call the law.
He's frostbitten. He's taller than his fingers. He was pitiful.
Occasionally, those covering the weather uncovered TMI, a little too much information.
I have 3 layers of fleece-lined pants.
Things are freezing on my body that I didn't even know were possible to freeze.
Probably somewhere south of her polar plexus. Ginny Moos, CNN.
This is the polar vortex, right?
New York.